yoga mobility work. So before you actually go fully into a yoga class, you need to begin by grounding yourself to start off with, because we're often rushing around and we just fly into our yoga classes by the seat of our pants, and then, you know, we've got all this turmoil that we've left behind, or, you know, stuck in traffic. So we have to come into your class and we have to ground. So that means coming into a nice easy pose, which is cross-legged pose, Sukhasana, and just relaxing and chilling down for a few moments, calming the mind, focusing on the breath, and really bringing ourselves right into the moment, because that's what yoga's about. It's not just about the exercise part of it, it's about the whole package that it mentally gives you. And really, that is probably not why a lot of people go into it in the beginning. They might go into it thinking, I'll give it a try, and maybe sometimes get frustrated with the meditation, relaxation sort of side of it. But by persevering, that's where you eventually get the huge amount there of the healing benefits of the asanas and the movement that you go into. So we're going to start off, imagine that we've done the grounding. I should put on a video about that another day. But this type of work that we're doing now, the mobility part, before you actually go into your asanas, your poses, is really good as well if you suffer from, if you haven't exercised for a while, or if you just want to do a warm up before you go into any type of exercise. These moves are really good. Or if you just simply want to just loosen off your joints. This is how we loosen off the joints, get all the synovial fluid running around your body, around your joints, mobilizing them, and then we'll get more prepared to do a little bit of a pulse raiser after that, which we, again, we'll do on another day. So going down, first of all, I'm going to go into Sukhasana, a nice seated position. So imagine we have grounded, we've been in a meditative pose, we've focused on our breathing, inhaling and exhaling for a minute. And then we're just going to mobilise, so we're placing hands down and reaching over into a seated, swaying palm, trap, tight movement. Inhale and out, and then exhale. Turn the hands. So there's little tiny things you can be doing to warm up, a little extra parts. That's like rotating the wrists as you go around one side and then the other. Into your moment. back. And one more. Hands behind, lift, in, scoop. Bigger circle now, if the arms feel ready to do full range of movement. If you're feeling crunchy bits, then imagine if you'd have just gone into a workout and you haven't really solved those crunchy bits in your shoulders before you do it. In, back, looking up. I'm not jerking my head, I'm just gently easing back into my shoulders, so nobody can see that on that video there, but I'm just leaning back into the arms, my gaze pointing upwards. And from there, then we're coming onto all fours, into cat and cow, but it's a moving cat and cow pose to start off with. So we're floating up, inhale and curl. So we're not holding anything. Exhale, inhale. Moving the ears away from the shoulders. Inhale and exhale. Inhale. And last one. So probably about four on each side, and then you would go to another little exercise, and maybe revisit it on the other, whatever you've just done. Maybe revisit it if you're still feeling stiff. Rotate. So we're lifting up on that rotation and round. Try not to swing the hips side to side. Inhale, rise. Exhale, down, floating with the arms. Round, reach. Round, reach. So then we change to the other side. So you can see we're going up and float. Up. Float. Reaching through. There's many nice little combinations you can do. Warm that body up, one, and two. And this is working all down the obliques, and lift, and then a little arm circle. If you've got tight shoulders, you will find that one arm, and one leg, whatever, one side of your body is completely different, wants to move completely different. So we're resetting there. Spread, make strong handprints into the mat. And from there, we're going to just pull in from the core, and we're going to just hover. So you've just engaged the core. So you're waking that up, and then release down. Your gaze is forward. I know I'm doing a lot of head moving around, but your head should maintain in alignment with your spine. So you're lifting up, and release. Pushing up. Release. And then you can start to go a little bit higher, up and down. So working towards Ardha Mukha Svanasana, down dog, and release. Up, push back, oh nice stretch, and release. Lift, through each vertebra all the way up. And then you start to go into your pulse raiser, where we're raising the heart rate up a little bit before